Hello, I'm Pharmacist Virginia, and this is magnesium sulfate paste. And here's what you need before we get into how to use it. It comes in a small pot and you can find it from most pharmacies. You'll need something flat and non-reactive, so a stainless steel flat butter knife, an alcohol wipe or soap and water, and a non-adherent small wound pad and tape, or you can use a plaster. So on my left thumb, I have the plaster with magnesium sulfate paste, and my right thumb has the wound dressing pad and tape. So let's go through how we got here with the plaster and the dressing with the magnesium sulfate paste. When you first get magnesium sulfate paste, it will look like this in a small pot, and it has a seal, which is like a plastic ring that you have to pull off around the edge of the lid. Once you've taken this plastic seal off, it means that the container is no longer childproof, so you can take off the lid really easily, and you need to keep it away from children or animals. Magnesium sulfate paste works by osmosis, so it helps to draw things out of the skin. So this can be helpful for removing any pus out of a boil, a splinter from wood, metal, glass, or plastic, and anything else like an ingrown hair or a cactus hair or nettle stings. Now I am cleaning the stainless steel knife with an alcohol wipe so I can mix the magnesium sulfate paste inside the pot. So you don't want to put your finger inside, otherwise you can contaminate it. You can also wash the knife or anything you're going to use to mix the paste with soap and water, which would be better than an alcohol wipe. We need to mix up the magnesium sulfate paste that's inside the pot. Otherwise, it's not going to be very easy to apply onto your skin. You'll probably mix it for about 1 or 2 minutes. Next, get your plaster or your non-adherent small wound dressing pad and some tape. So I'll show you how to use both of these. I'm going to put a blue mark on my thumb to show the place that I'm trying to cover up with the magnesium sulfate paste. And this could be a place where there is a splinter or a boil that might be painful and you want to get the pus out. Or there might be a hair or something inside your skin. So simply scoop out some magnesium sulfate paste from the pot and just place it on top of the skin. There is no need to rub it in. And if it looks like you've put too much, don't worry, you just need enough to cover the area. Now simply open up the plaster and place it on top. And it's just as quick and easy as that. Just as a reminder, if there's anything that is really deep inside the skin, magnesium sulfate paste might not be what you need to use. So please see a healthcare professional. So for my other thumb, I'm going to draw another blue mark. Don't worry, this pen does wash off with water. And now I'm going to open my wound dressing, which is sterile. So I don't want to touch it with anything other than my skin. And again, I'm going to put a small amount of magnesium sulfate paste on top and just spread it on there nicely. And then put any that's left over back inside the pot. And put the lid back on. And then put that somewhere safe out of reach of children and any pets. Now I'm going to pick up the wound dressing and apply my thumb to it and just put it on top like that, and it will stick. And then I can get some tape, and this is easy tear dressing tape. I could just hold tape in place with one finger and then roll it around the dressing. Not too tight, I don't want to cut off any circulation, and just one or two rounds of tape and then tear it off. And now I can leave my dressings on for about 6 to 12 hours. I can change them two or three times a day. And then if I haven't extracted what I want to get out of the skin, then after 2 days, I should see a healthcare professional. So you use the paste two or three times a day for 2 days. So what does it look like when you need to change your dressing? Magnesium sulfate paste is not absorbed by your skin. So what will happen is it will stay on the surface and it will even stick to the inside of the dressing. Like you can see here on the plaster, the magnesium sulfate paste just sticks to the dressing. And here I'm going to take the tape off on my other thumb with the small wound pad. And once I've done that, you'll be able to see that the same thing has happened. The magnesium sulfate paste will have stuck just to the dressing and my skin would not have absorbed it. So when you want to apply magnesium sulfate paste two or three times a day, you need a fresh dressing every time. So don't just put some new magnesium sulfate paste on and then use the same plaster or wound pad that you had on before. So you'll need a fresh alcohol wipe or soap and water to clean your stainless steel knife again. And then you might need to stir the magnesium sulfate paste like you did last time and then apply some more on top and do the same thing again. So we're going to either put a plaster on, or here we're going to put a new wound dressing pad. Both sides of the wound dressing pads are shiny and you can just put it on top and then get some more tape and do the same thing that we did last time, just to tape it on top. So hold the tape down with one finger and then roll it around with the other hand. Don't worry if it slips, it's okay. Just keep going. And then tear the tape off again. So that's a fresh new dressing. And you can twist it around if it's loose enough, so don't put it on too tight. Thank you for watching, and watch the next video where I answer all your questions about magnesium sulfate paste.